Good day to all. Welcome to this tutorials section on electrostatics. So this is the second part of the unit 1, electrostatics. So if you doesn't watch the videos which are created by me on electrostatics, the derivations of line charge, surface charge, volume charge and the ring charge densities, please watch my videos which are in my channel. So after watching that videos, only you must have to come for this particular problem section, because without watching those videos you cannot understand what is going on inside these problems sections. So kindly watch the videos which are put in my channel. So as the first problem, a point charges 1 millicoulomb and minus 2 millicoulomb are located at 3, 2, -1 and -1, -1, -4 respectively. Calculate the electric force on 10 nanocoulomb charge located at 0, 3, 1 and electric field intensity at that point. So what are all the data given? Are the two point charge values are given, locations are given. So 1 millicoulomb is located at 3, 2, -1 and minus 2 millicoulomb is located at -1, -1, -4. So you have to calculate the electric force of charge 10 nano on charge 10 nanocoulomb which is located at 0, 3, 1, and you have to find out the electric field intensity also at that point. So what is the formula for the electric force on a particular charge is q1 q2 divided by 4πε₀r² This you know in the previous videos. You can also write this particular unit vector in the form of vector format r minus rk, which is the distance from the r to the rk. So r minus rk divided by this particular magnitude. So this magnitude is going to be called as r, that is the distance between q1 and q2. So that is what given in this particular vector calculation, and whose magnitude is going to be divided, that's why it will generate this particular unit vector. So we are writing this particular vector representation as r vector divided by again the r square is inside that formula itself. So r square into this particular term is written as r by r minus rk divided by r. So that r and this r square will become as r cube. So that's why the formula has come as q1 q2 r vector divided by 4πε₀r³. So what are the values you need to find out is this r vector and this r, the magnitude of r. So these two things have to be found out. First thing, so you have to find out the charge and the force due to this particular charge on this particular charge, and also you have to find out the force of this charge on this charge. So you have to find out two forces due to this 1 millicoulomb first, due to this minus 2 millicoulomb second. You have to notice one thing, that this particular first 1 millicoulomb charge is positive charge, and this test charge, that is this 10 nanocoulomb test charge, is also positive. So these two positive charges will repel each other. And also another one charge is minus 2 millicoulomb, which is located as located at minus 1 comma minus 1 comma 4. So this this particular minus charge have attractive force with this 10 nanocoulomb charge. So what you have to do is you have to find out two different components of this force on this particular charge due to the 1 millicoulomb and minus 2 millicoulomb. So after finding out these two values, you have to sum up that particular values to find out the net force on the particular 10 nanocoulomb charge. From that you have to find out what is the electric field intensity at that point. So first you have to find out the QT. So what is the first force on T due to the first charge Q, that is the 1 millicoulomb, is QT, that is the test charge. QT means it is a test charge. It is plus 10 nanocoulomb, which is equal to 10 into 10 10 power minus 9 coulomb. Q1 is 1 into 10 power minus 3 coulomb. Q2 is minus 2 into 10 power minus 3 coulomb. So you have to find out the force on this test charge due to this first charge, that is the 1 millicoulomb. So QT, Q1 into the R vector between this QT and this Q1. So I can write this as RT, that is the position of this particular test charge, and minus the first charge's position. So if I subtract these two, and I can divide with the magnitude of that particular distance as cube. So RT1 cube will be on the denominator. So the second force is FT2, which is equal to QT Q2 into RT minus R2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught RT2 cube. So this is RT1 cube, which is the distance between the first charge and the test charge. RT2 is the distance between the second charge and the test charge. So you have to find out what is the FT1. So FT1 can be found out from QT is 10 into 10 power minus 9, which we know, and Q1 is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 3, which also we know. RT is the test charge point, so 0 comma 3 comma 1. You just write minus R1 is the 3 comma 2 comma minus 1. So you have to write this 2, and you have to subtract between these two values. And also, what is RT1? RT1 is the subtraction of these two particular point values, and you have to make as root. So square of the subtraction of each parameters on this particular each coefficients of the particular vector will be subtracted and found out the magnitude. And if you make the squares of the particular magnitude and making the addition of those squares into the square root, you will be getting the distance between those two charges. And we want the cube of that particular distance. So root of this particular thing, power 3, will be written as 3 by 2. So what we have to find out is you need to subtract these two points. So 0 minus 3 is minus 3 square, 3 minus 2 is 1, 1 square, 1 minus minus 1 is 1 plus 1. So this is 2 square power 3 by 2. So why this 3 by 2 has come? Because we need to take root of this particular summed squares. So these summed squares have been taken root means, and we need to put a cube root cube for this particular root value. So this root value and this cube will be connected with the 3/2. So this term will be generated. Also, we need to find out what is this 4 pi epsilon naught. Epsilon naught value is 8.854 × 10⁻¹2, which can also be written as 10⁻⁹ divided by 36 pi. These particular values are derived previously in our video itself on the Coulomb's law and the electric field video. We have given enough input how this particular epsilon naught has came. You can refer that video. So what is the value of 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 × 10⁻⁹ meter per farad. So you can represent this particular 4 pi epsilon naught as 9 × 10⁻⁹. You need not to remember these things. You just remember what is the epsilon naught. It is far enough. So you just substitute these values instead of 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, 9 × 10⁻⁹ can be substituted. So you can simplify this particular thing as 10⁻¹. How? −9 × 10⁻³ is −10⁻¹2. Okay, 10⁻¹2 × 10 is 10⁻¹11. Into this 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught can be written as 9 × 10⁻¹. You can make this subtraction as a vector format, which we can write 0, −0, −3 is −3 ax cap, 3 − 2 is 1, so 1 × a power ay cap, 1 − −1 is 2, so 2 az cap. So if you want to find out these values, then you can write this as 0.172 × 10⁻², into −3 ax cap plus ay cap plus 2 az cap. So you can simplify this particular vector as the vector which we got this answer. So second one is FT2, which we can find out from this formula, that is Q2 × RT − R2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught RT2 cube. So how to find out these values? I already know what is 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Just substitute that value, and Q2 is 10 nanocoulomb, so 10 × 10⁻¹ into −2 × 10⁻³, which is the Q2 value, which is a negative charge. So we can write like this, into RT, that is 0, 3, 1, because this is the test charge position. So 0, 3, 1 minus R2, the second charge position, which is −1, −1, 4. So if you want to find out the subtraction between these two, so 1 square, 3 minus of minus 1 is 4, so 4 square, 1 minus 4, so that is −3, so 3 square power 3/2. So if you find out the value, if you substitute the value of 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, we can get 9 × 10⁻. Here a minus is there, so −2 × 10⁻¹₁. Okay, so how this 11 has came? So we can make this 2, and if you simplify this, then we will be getting 2 × 10⁻¹₁. What is this value? So you can write in the vector format 0, −1 is +1 ax vector plus 3, −1 is 4, so 4 into ay, 1 minus 4 is minus 3, so minus 3 az vector. So if you simplify, you will be getting this answer. So you need to find out what is the total force. So total force is the addition of these two forces, so you will be getting this answer. After that, if you want to find out what is the electric field intensity, that is E vector is equal to F divided by Q. What you need to find out is, you need to find out the electric field intensity at the point where this particular 10 nanocoulomb charge is located. So you need to find out this particular electric field intensity on the 10 nanocoulomb charge only. So what you have to do is, you had found out what is the total force on that particular charge. So you just write those value, minus 6.518 ax vector, minus 3.712 ay vector, plus 7.5254 az vector into 10 power minus 3, because we are getting the value of milli newton. So 10 power minus 3 into this value divided by the charge value 10 into 10 power minus 9. So if you simplify this value, you will be getting the answer as this particular vector